Hey, welcome back to another Apple Motion edition of Apple A Day. Today's tutorial is in response to a request I had in the comments. The request was to see if I could recreate the Northern Lights in Apple Motion. Thank you so much to Travel Addicts Life for watching, and thanks for the question. I experimented with a few techniques using particles and replicators, but I wasn't having a very convincing result. So I did some searching and came across a post on discussions.apple.com. A helpful user by the name of Fox M had a great idea to use a brush stroke with variations to the jitter property. And even though his example wasn't perfect, it was a very cool approach and he was definitely on the right track. It just needed some work to make it look a little more realistic. There are many different looks to the Northern Lights, and I must have viewed 100 images online. I ended up settling on one style, and that's what we're going to create today. And here is the finished product. So we're going to make this from scratch. Now let's get started. So there are two sets of lights that we're going to draw, and there's one on top and one on the bottom. We'll start with the top one. So I'm going to grab the pen tool and draw the first curve, the top curve. I'm going to start right about here. I've got another point there, another one down here, another one up here, and then come off the screen about there. So I'm going to go to the inspector and go down to shape. I'm going to turn off fill because we don't need that. I'm going to go to brush color and set it to a bright green. Roughly there. And what's important is we need to change the brush type to airbrush. And when I do that, it enables the stroke tab up here. So I'm going to click on that. And once I'm in the stroke pad, I'm going to go down to the jitter property. I'm going to open up this disclosure triangle to show the X and Y values. I'm going to set the X to 4000 and the Y to 500. This ends up creating a pattern that's very similar to a particle generator, except that the particles here don't move, at least not yet. Another thing I want to do is set the brush scale to 200%. Oops. With a randomness also of 200. Now, I don't think we have quite enough particles on screen here, so in order to fix that, I'm going to go back to Style, and down where it says Spacing. Now, if we lower that value, it's going to make the spacing between the particles created by using Airbrush and Jitter, it's going to make that spacing smaller, so it's going to make them more dense. So if I put in 5%, you'll see a lot more particles suddenly pop into existence because they're crammed in closer together. And since I'm here, I'm going to turn on additive blend to improve the brightness and the glow. So now we need to add a little bit of animation. I'm going to go back to the stroke tab, back down to jitter to the X value. I'm going to click on the drop down, and under add parameter behavior, I'm going to choose oscillate. And I'm going to set the amplitude to 1200%. And I think we can leave the speed at 10. And if we play this back, you'll see that the brush particles created from the jitter property are slowly moving back and forth. But in order to make this look like the Northern Lights, we need to add some blur. So I'm going to move my timeline back to the beginning. And I forgot to name this group that the path is in, so I'm going to select that and name it Northern Lights Top. So in order to get a decent look for these Northern Lights, we're going to add three blurs. I'm going to add a zoom blur, a vertical directional blur, and then a horizontal directional blur. Let's start with the zoom blur. So with the group selected, I'm going to go to filters, down to blur, and I'm going to choose zoom blur. I'm going to set the amount to 4.0. And then we have to move the center because we want the zoom blur to shoot upwards, not at the camera. So we're just going to drag, oops, wrong way. So we're going to drag that down to the negative values until it looks about right. Say something like that. Now, depending on where you positioned your curve, you may have a different value than what I have here. But I think that looks pretty good like that. I'm actually going to move my path down on the screen a little bit. I'm just going to go to properties to the Y position and just drag that down. this zoom blur that we just created looks a little choppy, so I'm going to add a directional blur in order to soften it a bit. So make sure my playhead is at the beginning. I'm going to select the Northern Lights top group. And under filters and blur, I'm going to choose directional blur. And we want this to be vertical, so I'm going to change the angle to 90 degrees. And I'm going to set the amount to 200. So playing that back, it doesn't look too bad. Although I do think those vertical lines that we have are a little bit harsh, so we need to soften those too. I'm going to stop that. Put my timeline back to the beginning. Select the group and go under filters. And I'm going to add another directional blur. And I'm going to leave the angle at zero because we want this to be horizontal. And I'm going to set the amount to 100. And playing this back, we suddenly have something that looks pretty realistic. So to add a little more realism, I'm going to create another curve, kind of like an S, in this area here. So I'm going to go to the pen tool and start off screen right about here. I'm going to put a curve there. Put another curve off screen about here. And move down and finish the path right about there. And just like before, we're going to go under shape and turn off fill. But I do want to put this path into its own group. So I'm just going to drag this outside and rename the group to Northern Lights Bottom. I'm going to drag it underneath. Go back to the path. We need to set the brush color to green. I'm going to make this a darker green though. Close the colors. Change the brush type from solid to airbrush. Turn on additive blend. Set the spacing to 5. And go over to stroke. And back down to jitter. And I'm going to put different values in here than we did in the first curve. I'm going to set the horizontal jitter to 2000. And the vertical to 400. And of course, we have to animate the X coordinate in the jitter property. So I'm going to click on the drop down and go to add parameter behavior and again choose oscillate. For the amplitude, we're going to put in 1000, a little bit less than what we had in the original curve, which I think we set to 1200. And now I want to copy the three blurs that we already created in the Northern Lights top. I'm going to select them and hit Command C to copy them. And select Northern Lights Bottom, press Command V to paste, and there they are. I also want to rotate the bottom lights a little bit clockwise, just so that the animation doesn't appear to be lined up with the top Northern Lights. So I'm just going to rotate this by -4 degrees. And I think I want to give this bottom one a little bit more vertical blur. So we had the amount set to 200, I'm going to up that to 400. Just to kind of soften it a little bit. So I'm going to deselect everything. And if I play this back, I think that looks pretty good. The movement is very subtle, and of course it's very difficult to replicate the exact look of the Northern Lights, but what we have here is pretty recognizable. And as always, you can adjust any of these settings to modify the look and the behavior and the style. Well, that's it for creating the Northern Lights in Apple Motion. I hope you found this valuable, and thanks again for the ideas in the comments. Please keep them coming. Thanks again for watching. I'm John Martins. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Apple a Day.